blood flows, you've also got contact, and we encourage everyone to jump on our 13/19/40 website, Queensland Transport website, for up-to-date details of all road closure points.
Well,
I've
got
Emerald
Yeah, look, resourcing hasn't been an issue to date. We have had a very widespread event. We've been very careful in managing people's fatigue. People working tired is dangerous, particularly with the work that our volunteers do out in the field. So we're confident at this stage that we've got sufficient personnel. We've gathered a lot of people across the whole of the state government that can be brought to bear. This is a coordinated, all-in event. So we get lots and lots of assistance from a range of agencies. So at this stage, there's no real concerns with resourcing.
Has it helped that this has been a relatively slowly unfolding disaster, even though it's a huge change? We've had time to see what's going on.
Yeah, that and the fact that the cleanup from this hasn't really started yet. The issues have been primarily around getting information to people so that they can make the right preparations. Certainly, our volunteers and others have been helping people in the community less able, so the elderly and so on, in making those preparations. And as well, some of the things around swift water rescue and flood boat operations and resupplying people who are isolated. But it's not like, for example, a cyclone where we have one rapid onset issue with lots and lots of devastation and people cleaning up debris and a whole range. Yes, the slow onset has certainly helped with the resources.
You mentioned earlier about
some places that could take weeks before the water starts receding.
Can you expand on that a little bit more in terms of how widespread
that
type of wave is? Is that
just going to be one spot? Look, it's probably too difficult to go into all of the particular areas, but largely the major river systems that will be charged from all the tributaries will take probably days or weeks to go down. Water, for example, is flowing down through the Condamine the Long. That's not likely to reach the water probably until the middle or the end of January. The water that's going down the Fitzroy to Rockhampton won't get there until early next week. So this water does take a long time to flow down the systems. And because there's so much, that backs up some of the tributaries as well. So I think the message is that expect that these waters will stay up. During today is the expectation, and that's probably likely to be a reasonable long thing as well.
There was a release from police this morning saying that the town of Baralaba
I think we'll find a peak in Bundaberg during today, tonight probably. Hemel on Friday. And a bit hard to tell with Rockhampton at this stage, but I think we'll find the waters there will start to get pretty high Sunday. How long that takes to peak is too early for us to tell at this stage. Look, I think we will find that that will be an issue that will probably peak today. How widespread it is, it's going to be on a case-by-case basis. In some areas, the town water is fine. stop pumping, but they've got, you know, 2, 3, 4, 5 days supply. In some of the smaller areas with rainwater tanks and so on, that those tanks have been inundated, then they'll probably flood down so, yeah, it's a horses for courses type of thing, so very difficult in general response for that.
Are there any questions?
We're talking to the ADF at the moment with a view to keeping those on standby. You know, with the unfolding situation in Rockhampton and so on, I can see that there's probably a good use for those, but we'll be in close contact with the ADF around what we're using them for. There's one in the roof at the moment, and there's one on the ground at Nickel.
Are there any special arrangements
for
the
Yeah, we'll be working closely with the council around what support they need. That's a council asset, but if council need any additional support to be able to get that back on track, then clearly the state government will coordinate that for.
What about trucking north?
Look, if that's needed, then that's obviously a possibility, whether it's bottled water or whatever, but we'll ensure that the people of Dalby
Thank you very much.